The year was 1995, and Toy Story had revolutionized the world of animation. Not only was it the first computer animated film to be released in theaters, but it proved that animated movies could be more than the traditional Disney formula. There were no princesses or musical numbers, and the film's story had a depth and humor that appealed to adults almost as much as kids. But that wasn't all. You see, Toy Story reintroduced classic baby boomer toys to its audiences. We're talking Etch A Sketch, Mr. Potato Head, and Slinky. The movie was totally banking on the nostalgia of our parents, and we didn't even know it. But it's a good thing it did, because without Toy Story, these childhood favorites probably wouldn't be around today. So let's go back in time to see how the Toy Story franchise saved a generation of classic toys. Let's start with Slinky. He wasn't always the dog we know him as today. I know, he doesn't look all that impressive, but Slinky was one of the hottest toys of the 50s and 60s. The idea behind the Slinky came to naval engineer Richard James in 1943, when he accidentally pushed a spring off his desk. He thought the way it slinked to the floor would make it the perfect child's toy. And after searching through the dictionary, his wife, Betty James, settled on the name Slinky. It wasn't an instant hit, and sales were slow for a few years. But one day, a Philadelphia department store gave the toy its own display case just in time for Christmas in 1945. All 400 Slinkies were gone in under 2 hours. Richard and Betty had a hit on their hands, so naturally, the next course of action was to make more. So Richard opened shop in Albany, New York, after developing a machine that could produce the Slinky within seconds. The toy was packaged in a black lettered box, and advertising commenced in America. Every baby boomer remembers this catchy jingle.
It's Slinky, for fun, it's a wonderful toy.
In 1952, Slinky Dog made his debut, a small plastic dog whose front and rear ends were joined by a metal Slinky. He looked a lot different back then, as Betty James said herself, not nearly as cute as the Toy Story version. Over the next few years, several other Slinky toys were introduced. The Slinky's success continued well into the 60s and 70s, but its pace began to slow in the 1980s, when more sophisticated toys were hitting the shelves. Spoiler alert, Toy Story would change everything. James Industries was thrilled to learn that Slinky Dog would be a character in the film, and gave Pixar their blessing for Slinky Dog to be redesigned by Pixar artist Bud Lucky. The toy's new look would make him more appealing as an animated character.
I got some bad news.
Bad news?
James Industries had been out of business for 10 years prior to Toy Story's release, but Toy Story's booming success would rake in 50,000 new orders for the company and put them back in business. Oh, the power of product placement. One of Toy Story's most memorable characters, Mr. Potato Head, was launched by the Hasbro company in 1953. If you're a millennial like me, you probably weren't aware that the original Mr. Potato Head only contained parts, such as eyes, ears, noses, and mouths. Why? Because parents were expected to supply their children with real potatoes for the head. And although the toy was called Mr. Potato Head, it was suggested that any fruit or vegetable could be used. It wasn't until 1964 that a hard plastic body was introduced, replacing the need for a real potato. Over the next 3 decades, a variety of Mr. Potato Head products were sold, including a Mrs. Potato Head and 2 children, named Brother Spud and Sister Yam. Mr. Potato Head continued to remain a popular classic toy, producing an animated series titled Potato Head Kids, and becoming the spokesbud for the American Cancer Society in 1987, the same year his trademark pipe was taken away. Unlike Slinky Dog, Mr. Potato Head never disappeared from the public eye. He just wasn't the coolest kid on the block anymore. But that would all change with a little film called, you know. Sales of the Mr. Potato Head toy increased 800% after Toy Story's release. Toy Story added eyebrows to their character interpretation of Mr. Potato Head, and his new look influenced Hasbro to add eyebrows to their Potato Head line. The standard Mr. Potato Head sold for about $6, but their new Toy Story model, featuring more parts and a bowler hat, sold for a hefty $11. And this brings us to everyone's favorite drawing toy, the Etch-A-Sketch. In 1959, a French electrician named Andre Casson, had the idea for the toy while installing a light switch plate that was coated in aluminum powder. After making some pencil marks on the powder, he noticed that the marks were also visible on the other side of the plate. He used the idea of making electrostatic designs to develop what he called the magic screen. The Ohio Art Company bought the design from Casson in 1959 for $25,000, and the rest was history. The Etch A Sketch hit toy stores in 1960 and was sold for $2.99. It went on to sell 600,000 units that year alone and quickly became one of the most popular toys of the baby boom era. By the 1980s, new models such as a pocket version were added to the product line. But like Slinky and Mr. Potato Head, Etch A Sketch couldn't fend off new high-tech toys, particularly video games. But then, of course, the toy's popularity would skyrocket in 1995. Toy Story was released, featuring a scene with Etch A Sketch in a draw duel with Woody. This 12-second scene was enough to give Etch A Sketch a significant sales boost, requiring the production line to work overtime to meet demand. But despite all of this, the Ohio Art Company would later fall into severe financial trouble from canceled orders of various products, reaching a point where the fate of the company was in question. But once again, Toy Story came to the rescue. Toy Story 2 featured an Etch-A-Sketch being used to present sketches related to the investigation of Woody's kidnapping. At 45 seconds, the scene in question was much longer than the scene in the original movie. The exposure from the highly successful film resulted in sales of the Etch-A-Sketch increasing by 20% and ensured the survival of the Ohio Art Company. Of all the classic toys featured in Toy Story, Etch-A-Sketch has experienced the greatest increase in toy sales, that being a 4,000% increase. The company reports today that they have sold over 175 million units. So that's how Toy Story saved you and your parents' favorite childhood toys from extinction. James Industries, Hasbro, and Ohio Arts Company owe a lot to the franchise. They certainly benefited from all the free advertising, and parents could rejoice as well. Their kids wanted to play with the same toys that they had played with, and this made it easy to join in on the fun. Hasbro confirmed that most of their buyers in the mid-90s were parents who played with Mr. Potato Head as children. The Ohio Art Company had a similar statement, saying, "Mothers are a market, and mothers are being reminded by the movie about that nostalgic feeling of playing with an Etch-A-Sketch." So in the age of Power Rangers, Game Boys, and Super Nintendo, the old-fashioned had again become fashionable, thanks to a little Pixar magic. This week, Toy Story 4 is introducing audiences to even more characters based off of classic vintage toys, like Gabby Gabby, a take off of the Chatty Cathy doll, and Duke Kaboom, a take off of Evil Knievel. Yeah, they don't exactly match their original counterparts, but they still pay homage to the toys that inspired them, and are sure to bring back that sweet nostalgia for older audiences. I have no doubt that the newest installment of the Toy Story franchise will, like all the Toy Story films, have a little something for everyone. So, did you have any of these toys growing up? And if you did, was it because of the Toy Story films? I'd love to know. I spent hours on my Etch-A-Sketch, and I also had a Magna Doodle, which I believe was made by the same company. It was very difficult to draw on an Etch-A-Sketch, even now as an adult. So let me know in the comments if you had any of those toys. All right, y'all, thank you so much for watching, and as always, have a magical day.